Hey, all, this is Marissa Skell, and I want to send out a big shout-out thank you to Tony Has Nine Fingers.
What is going on, people? It is day number 4 of the 31 Days Half October. This is my series where I'm doing 31 movie reviews in 31 days. That's right. I might sprinkle a few extras in there like I did last year. If you didn't check out my last year's, you know, month-long review sesh, definitely go ahead, check that out right after this review, and then check the 3 I did before this. Anyway, a lot of people are doing it, so check my show notes or check the description for all the other people that I know of right now that are doing it. If you're also doing it, let me know, and I'll post your page on the bottom of this. But anyway, I'm doing more indie reviews, more lower budget, more B-rated, more movies that most people probably haven't heard of, as well as I'm doing it in alphabetical order. So I'm doing it a little bit different than some people. Some people are doing the 1920s till now. Some people are just kind of randomly going, watching a movie, and then reviewing it. So today is day number 4, so the letter that goes with that is D. And if you couldn't tell by the title, I'm reviewing the movie called Detention. This came out in 2011. I actually picked it up earlier this year. I saw a trailer for it. Now, I didn't really hear of it, so I picked it up to check it out. It's directed and written by Joseph Kahn. It's also written by Mike Palermo. It stars Josh Hutcherson. I know him from, what was it, Zathora, whatever, the spaced version of, what do you want to call it, Jumanji. That kind of reminded me. Stars Shanley, Caswell, and Spencer Locke, or Locke, probably Locke. I'm going with Locke. Anyway, this movie is going to be a little... I'm not going to try to explain the whole thing because there's a lot that goes on in this movie. It's a horror comedy, which I do adore. Probably my favorite genre of horror. You know, you got horror, but then you got the subcategories. You got the sub... the different branches, I guess you want to call it, of horror. Well, this is a horror comedy based in a high school. So that's, you know, easy to explain. It's pretty much got a killer. It has to do with time travel. It has to do with aliens. That's where it kind of jumbles and gets, you know, all over the place. So at points, I don't want to say it's hard to follow because it's pretty much straightforward. It's not like going into crazy tangents that you don't understand, you don't follow it. But it does, you know, like I said, there is time travel in this. There's a spin-off, or not spin-off, but there's a murderous copycat killer, I guess you want to call it. I'm guessing they have their own, like, Scream-type movie in the movie. And there's a killer called Cinderhella, which... now someone's dressed as this person and trying to kill people. So to find out what's going on and who's doing what in time, they kind of have to... all these kids are in detention. And pretty much they have to... certain people have to go back in time to figure out what's going on. And if they don't figure out by a certain time, then everybody's screwed kind of deal. So it's, like I said, it's... I'm not even an attempt to kind of go crazy into the plot line or storyline or anything like that. But I'll leave it at a horror comedy movie with, well, based in high school, with time travel, with aliens, with a killer at the same time. It's all mashed into one movie. I thought it was, you know, I've seen different reviews or whatever. Some people say they don't understand it, or it's too much, or, you know, this movie, it doesn't take itself too seriously. People said they can't get into the characters. You know, certain movies aren't meant to have, you know, you have your instant, you know, people you care for, not care for, or want to see die, or want to see live through the entire movie. You know, it has this, but it's not, like, character-driven. You don't get too in-depth with each character. I must say, some of the kills are pretty cool. Again, it's a horror comedy, so you get these not laugh-out-loud moments all the time, but, you know, I did giggle and laugh at certain points. But it was definitely interesting. Again, this came out in 2011, and it was one that, you know, I did not know about. I did not, you know, hear about it. But seeing a trailer for it, I'm like, eh, let me definitely give this one a chance. I dug it. Again, it is all over the place, so it's one to, you know, you'll find yourself like, what's going on at any given time? But me, myself, I'm a fan of that. So if you're a fan of that as well, I think this movie has its a niche. It's almost like certain movies you watch, see, like, Troll 2 has its, you know, niche crowd. You know, some people look at it and this is, you know, horrible. But other people are looking at it and they find the stuff they like in it. This one might be the same way, because some people don't like the bounciness. Some people don't like the, it's doing this at one point and doing this at another point and doing this over here and doing that over there kind of deal. But there's other people that love it. Other people, you know, like the spontaneousness of it and whatever. But I definitely dug it. A horror comedy, high school horror comedy with aliens, with time travel, with a serial killer on the loose. It's definitely one that, you know, is very entertaining. So I'll leave the link to the trailer for it so you can check it out as well. I'll leave the link to everything I'm talking about, as well as the other people doing this 41. There's 41 days in October now, just in case you were wondering. 31 days of October. Mine, 31 days hath October, other people's 31 days of Halloween. So check out the show notes for everything. As I'm doing this throughout the month, I'm also trying to get 1,000 subscribers. I'm on a race to 1,000. So if I get it by the end of October, I will do a big giveaway. I have a few movies in mind and a few things to give away. So if you're watching this and you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. If you know other people who like horror movies and haven't heard of, you know, some of the lower budget ones, send them my way, because not only am I doing it now, I've done it, you know, that's pretty much what my channel is, reviews, top fives, and all this stuff, unboxing. So definitely, again, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, let people know I'm out here, check everybody else's, you know, 31 days of Halloween, and until tomorrow, I'll see you guys. If you found the review you just watched enlightening and you want more of them, go ahead, hit that subscribe button in the corner, and check out all the other reviews I have, such as Horror Pack Reviews and Netflix and Chiller. If you want to check out all the other things I have, go ahead and check out my Instagram, where I show off the movies I have behind me. Or check out my Twitter, where I post all my videos and more. If you want to do that, go ahead, hit those buttons, and until next time, I'll see you.